Gracious Father, we thank you that you have called all of us by the gospel. May we shine, Lord. Illuminate your gospel in all of the world around us so that others might know you. Please send your spirit upon us now. Teach us and lead us, Lord. Form us that we might be your people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. By grace, mercy, and peace be yours this day from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The text for this morning's meditation comes to us from our gospel lesson in Matthew chapter 5, wrong gospel. But as we begin, I'd like to invite you to pull out the chair Bibles that are either in front of you or underneath you. You're going to want to turn to Matthew 5. Because we're going to be looking beyond what our text is for today, and we're going to need some participation. So Matthew 5 is on page 809 if you have a small print Bible. I know there's two different versions out there. 809, Matthew 5. While you're opening to Matthew 5, what are some names that you would hope people would call you, or some things about you that would describe you, that you'd like for people to say about you? Perhaps he's kind. He's a kind man. Or she's caring. You want people to describe you that way? He's good natured, whatever that means. She really sacrifices herself for others. He puts other people first. He's really strong. She's real courageous. But what are some of those other words that you could go by? He's unkind at times. She's not always so considerate. Sometimes it seems like he's in a hurry. We'll just blow right past him without saying hi. Right? Sometimes it seems like she can't control her tongue. Sometimes he's a gossip king. Certainly those things are describing you, right? No, only good things. But actually, I do have something that I'd like to tell you there, or call you. Don't get mad at me. It's not a bad thing. It's not my word. It's Jesus. Where he says to each one of us, you are the salt of the earth. And you are the light of the world. Now, when we first hear those words, it might mean a little bit to us. We know what light means. It brightens the situation. It allows for us to see clearly. It assists us to do whatever job we're going to do. But the salt, and we know we use salt to give things some flavor, right? Our doctors tell us to stop putting so much on. We know that the salt preserves. I heard back in the day, people use it as a disinfectant for newborn babies. I don't think we still do that anymore. No, okay. The OBs say, no. The salt is good for measurements. Its currency was used for. It's very, very valuable. But there's one thing we should know about this, though, is that if Jesus is the one saying it, then we know it's true. So there's really two questions we should be asking when thinking about this today. Is Jesus really talking about us? And what does it mean for us if it's true? Those are the two things. Is Jesus really talking about us? Are we really the salt of the earth and the light of the world? And what does that mean if we are the light of the world, the salt of the earth? What do we do now with that? So that's what we're going to look at today as we are in Matthew chapter 5. Now, I think the lectionary doesn't do us any favors by putting these verses together. I think truthfully, we probably should cut it in half. In the first four verses, what we're going to look at today, go with the Beatitudes from the first part of Matthew 5. And the last four verses go with the intro leading into chapter 6. So I don't think it does any favors as to describing what being light and being salt is all about. But what it means, though, for us in understanding that it's related to Matthew 5 is that we're blessed. Isn't that what the Beatitudes say? Blessed are those who? Blessed are the meek. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. It's saying that we are blessed. But maybe when you hear those words, you're like me. You want to take a step back and say, Lord, I don't know. I really can't be known by some of those other names. Sometimes I can be dishonest. Sometimes we don't always represent the Lord, the world around us. And when we think about our past and maybe some of the things that we've done, the coincidence of it, the circumstance of it, and the way that it's played out in our lives, we're still paying for the things that we've done. Maybe we're crippled by what we've done. Maybe we've turned a blind eye to people who needed us. Or perhaps we've turned a deaf ear to individuals who've called out for us. We haven't really acted as people who are blessed, right? Let's look at Matthew 5 and see what this is really all about. If you would please join me, and I hope you did turn to Matthew 5 because I'm going to make you read with me so I can make sure you don't fall asleep. We're going to look at Matthew 5, starting with verse 3. I'm going to say the first verse, the first half of the verse. You all chime in with the second half, okay? All right, with verse 3. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who mourn. Blessed are the meek. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Blessed are the merciful. Blessed are the pure in heart. Blessed are the peacemakers. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake. All right, we'll stop there. So, does this describe you? And truthfully, the answer to that question is found in the very first one that we read, the very first Beatitude, verse 3. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Oftentimes when we hear the word poor, we probably think of an individual that doesn't have any money. Maybe somebody that can't afford to even stay in the house. And sure, those individuals are poor, but that's not what Jesus means when he says poor. He's really referring to people who have without, regardless of any particular circumstance. So someone who can be poor is usually hurting. Or if there's someone that's struggling in life, they're poor. If someone lost a mother or a father, they're poor. They're really hurting. Their soul is tugging at them. In fact, one of the places this really is found is in Matthew chapter 11, where John the Baptist sends his disciples to Jesus. And they ask him, are you the one to come, Jesus? Or is there somebody else that we should be expecting? And Jesus says, well, tell John this. Tell John that those who are blind are now able to see. Those who are deaf, they can hear. Those who are dead are raised to life. And good news is preached to the poor. What's the good news? It's Him. It's the forgiveness. It's the grace. You see, who does Jesus come to? He doesn't really come to the Pharisees. He doesn't really come to the scribes. He doesn't come for the sake of the synagogues. But here, in Matthew chapter 5, we see Jesus' public teaching for the very first time. And he does it from some fishermen and what you call average people. And he opens his mouth, this one, for the very first time publicly, and he says these words, blessed are the wealthy, Pharisees, Sadducees, blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are you. Because isn't that how we come? As people who have hurts on our hearts? As people that have struggles? As people who have to face death in a lot of different circumstances in our lives? As people who have life that make things of gold, like we hope. Blessed are those who are poor in spirit, for theirs. And then here's the beautiful part. Every verb form we find here in Matthew chapter 5, it's future for the most part. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. But blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God. This word from Jesus, the first words that he says publicly, blessed are you, for you have presently the kingdom of God. I mean, that says a lot. Jesus was born to Virgin Mary. We hear the proclamation at his baptism, behold my son, with whom I am well pleased. Then with his word, with the authority, he goes into the desert and defeats the evil one with just his word. And then he says to us, first and foremost, blessed are you who are poor in spirit. The kingdom of God belongs to you. And then he goes and shows how he's going to give it to us. For he goes to the cross and dies the death that we deserve. Instead of you and me going to the cross, he takes the nails. And 3 days later is raised. His life, giving us life. We are the poor in spirit. So yes, when Jesus says, you are the salt of the earth and light of the world, he's talking to you, O poor in spirit. But there's still that question. What does it mean? The story of it. Well, here it is. This is God's plan for you. You don't have to buy all the books that tell you how you're supposed to live. I'm going to tell it to you right now, free of charge. If you want, you can mark it in the offering for me, okay? As a tip. Salt the earth. Illuminate the world. That's it. That's what Jesus called you to do. What it means is when you get up in the morning, tomorrow morning after the Super Bowl, and you're kind of tired because you stayed out way too late, and everybody else is walking into your business because the world is still really tired for Monday morning, you get to approach your day with a smile on your face, and in your mind you'll be thinking, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it, and you are bringing salt into your job. You are bringing the light of the world into your relationship. As there is anger and as there is frustration, but you stop yourself and you say, no, this is the person that I love. And I swore that I would give that person my all. Your calling is to salt the earth, to be the light of the world. And I did not say to salt the earth. You heard that, right? Salt the earth. That's your calling. Bear the light. Bring the salt. It's not an accident that you are in the circumstances that you are in. You are where you are because God has placed you there. Bring salt. Bring light. That's who you are. Eternally. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for allowing us to be part of your kingdom, for making us a part of your kingdom. Thank you for blessing us. We are poor in spirit, Lord, but you have gifted us with the kingdom. As we leave this place, as people who are blessed and don't deserve it, may we shed your light. May we be the salt. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.